side action, and we're just about set to kick off. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. We'll see how these two teams play in this game as they prepare for the opening kickoff. He'll return it from the one. Across the 30. Brought down by the kicker.
Hey, that's a pretty good return there to open this game up.
Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go. Got it. And he goes down quickly. Strike to his receiver, no good. That's going to bring up fourth down.
Great hold by the defense. They were expecting the pass play, and they defended it very well.
He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. He's got room to run. Tackle made around the 45-yard line. So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
Quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big game.
He's tackled around the 46-yard line. He's scrambling, and he's tackled around the 47-yard line. That's a gain of one on the play. Third down.
Seven's Mike. Mike seven.
Two, two. Switch. Caught, and big hit there to stop him. That'll be a 2-yard gain.
Not much of a gain for the wide receiver, but at least he made the catch and got himself some positive yards.
It away. Wait a minute, he's going to throw. Unable to convert on fourth down, and the ball changes hands. This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over. From the 49-yard line, second down. Caught out in the open. He's pushed out of bounds at the 46-yard line. A quarterback in the gun with five receivers. Got his man. Can't tack on any yardage. He'll try to knock this punt down inside the 20. I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. Quick throw. And he's taken down at the 34.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route, good protection, and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
Fires out to his wideout. They'll bring him down at a the 47-yard line. He has some room. He's taken down at the 42-yard line.
Everything about that play was crisp. The route, the throw, the catch, that's fun to see.
Now he tries to buy some time. Tackle right around the 34. 1, maybe 2 yards on the quarterback scramble. The 21-yard line.
That's good decision-making there and mechanics by the quarterback. He knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but he looked off the other receivers first.
From the 21-yard line, it's first down. Nice play to set up first and goal. Fights forward to about the 7. The back gets 3 on the carry. On the ground with the tailback. Tackle outside after a nice pickup.
That makes us 3-0.
Looking for his man, incomplete. Looks like they've decided to go for it here. He's on the run. Keeps it, and he's got a touchdown. They weren't able to defend the quarterback scramble, and they give up 6.
And he's one of those quarterbacks who can do this when he's close to the goal line. He'll pump fake, then take off, or he'll put his head down and crash it in. Anything goes with this guy.
He makes the PAT. An 11-play, 78-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
He's to the 20. At the 30. Tackle made at the 39. Utah State's got people flying all over the field on defense right now.
Boy, they sure do. Right now, we're just seeing great defensive effort. They have a plan. They understand it. They're playing with great speed, and they're not giving up big plays. That's why they're playing well up to this point.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that this defense is putting on him.
Now he's scrambling, and he's sacked. Defense hoping for another sack here on 3rd and long. He heaves it deep to the 20, and he holds it in. And they make the stop right around the 12-yard line. This game's already shaping up to be a good one as we head to the second quarter. 7-0, Utah State. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. Great pressure on the quarterback forced that incompletion.
Boy, they really pounded him on that throw.
That makes it second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 12-yard line. Little handoff, and down he goes at the 11-yard line. Dumps it complete over the middle. Touchdown, Utes.
These guys need to be aware this aerial attack is capable of making some big plays. They've got to get on their toes.
The extra point to tie this game up. And he adds the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 20. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. Scrambling around. Slides down to the ground. Bring him down in the backfield.
The option can be really tough to defend. At that time, it was well played by the defense.
It's third down, 8 to go. Ball on the 22-yard line. Fires to his receiver, first down.
Good job here by the receiver to look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
And he can't get away from the pressure.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
Makes it to the 38-yard line. He airs it out. Can't connect. And they're going to have to bring on the punt team.
It was a good hold by the defense on third down. Now their punt returner will get a chance to make something happen.
He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. Just throws this one away. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 49.
Check number 6. Let's go. We got Mike, number 53.
They go to the ground game. He makes it to the 48-yard line. He scrambled. They bring him down.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. That's what happened there.
So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. They'll line up with five wide receivers. He's going to try and scramble, and they got him.
The offensive line has to at least slow the guy down a little bit. He was in there in no time.
2 minutes left in the half. Gains his way to the 26-yard line. Looks like someone got a head start on the line.
False start.
They'll line up for another third down play because of the penalty.
Well, here you're in a third down situation, and then someone makes a mental mistake. It makes your blood boil if you're a coach.
Here's third and nine. Ball on the 21-yard line. Fires that quickly, incomplete. And that'll make it fourth down.
Yeah, they just couldn't connect on a pass there. That was a very good stand by this defense.
And he makes it out to about the 44-yard line.
I give the defense credit, but right now I think it's more a case of sloppy offense.
Yeah, you got to recognize that both defenses have come into this game with the right mindset. They're very well prepared. But I'm with you. It's one thing to have great defense. It's another thing when those defenses are going up against offenses that just are not clicking right now and hitting on all cylinders.
Quick shot to the open receiver, and he can't hang on to the ball. From the 44-yard line, second down. There's a very impressive open field tackle. The ball here and brought down to the backfield.
Man, did he play that perfectly or what? As a linebacker, you have to be able to read the offense and make a quick diagnosis, which is exactly what he did on that play.
Makes the catch and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss. Down and they need to get it to the 23. Another run. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. They're trying to pin them deep with a solid punt right here. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum. So as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. Tackled after a decent run up the gut. So at the end of the half, we're even at 7 in this one.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio, as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes.
We say it here all the time. It's not always about the X's and the O's. It can be about the Jimmys and the Joes. But I think Jimmy and Joe appear to be pretty evenly matched here, and this might not necessarily be about who has the better athlete, who has the more explosive player. This might come down to which guy maneuvering those X's and O's does so the most wisely.
Well, who's telling Jimmy and Joe where to line up? They gotta know where they're supposed to go. So I think it is important. And the coaches, sometimes you gotta break character. You know, sometimes you know you're a predominantly run team, and that's what you do, and you're gonna line up and pound it. But sometimes you face a good defense that's playing really well that they're not gonna allow you to do that. And sometimes you gotta get a little bit out of character. And I think which offense or which defense can take a few chances and get rewarded for those chances, come up on the plus side of it, create a big turnover, set your offense up on the right side of the field. How about you dial up one of those trick plays you got in your bag that you haven't used in a while that you think might could work and might could maybe bust open this game and give you a little bit of separation?
That'll do it here in the studio at halftime. We'll try to see if Pollack can bring a little energy in the second half. Got a lot of games to watch, including yours. Brad and Kirk, ready for the second half.
And the second half just about set to get started. We're dead even. Taken from the 3-yard line. He's tackled at the 23-yard line. You don't want to squander any possessions, but maybe now's the right time to dip into your bag of tricks a little. Think about some gadget plays to catch the defense napping. He's scrambling. He dives and he'll be marked down. First down grab by the receiver. Tackled right around the 40. That brings up second and 9. And he's going to be sacked for a loss.
That's a loss of 8 yards. That'll bring up 39.
Third and long now after the sack.
Four down. Seven's a Mike. Mike seven. Yeah.
Fires out to his receiver. Tackle made around the 42-yard line. Makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. Time's getting a little bit tighter now. You got to make every possession count. So the Aggies saw one of their key guys go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the action. Fires incomplete, knocked away.
Smart, heady play by that defender. That was solid, fundamental pass defense.
From their own 29-yard line, it's second down. Got hit and still completed it. And he's taken down at the 31.
Wow.
complete. He's got room to work. He's at midfield. And he's level at the 39-yard line. Carries the ball for a nice game.
That's a gain of 5 on the play. That'll bring up 30 inches.
And we got Mike, number 53. Mike, 53.
Tackle at about the 29-yard line. Looks like they've decided to go for it here. They're all tied in on the line here on 4th and short. Down at the 27.
You love having this kind of weapon. You already know what kind of damage he can cause in the passing game, and here you can see what he can do when you hand the ball off to him.
He gets out to about the 17-yard line. Middle for a nice run. Tackled after a decent pickup.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That makes it 2nd and 6.
Run and he's brought down. So it's 3rd down and they're just inches away from picking up the 1st down. Touchdown, Utah. Converts the extra point. The Utes had one of their key players go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the lineup. They line up to kick this one away. He's got the corner. He's to the 20. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 27-yard line.
Utah's coaching staff will go out tonight, and I think the offensive coordinator should buy the defensive coordinator his meal.
Well, the defense has been great. There's no doubt about it. But I just think that the offense that they're facing, they've just been so conservative, so predictable. It's made it very easy for this defense to have a dominant game.
He's on the run. He's taken down around the 29-yard line.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That'll make it 2nd and 7.
Drilled at the 38-yard line. And down he goes at the 50. Tries to buy some time, and they got him.
That makes it 2nd and 14.
So it'll be 2nd and 14 after the setback. And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this 5-receiver look. Now he's scrambling.
do better. Come on, QB, come on. Mike 7. Mike 7.
Yeah. Strike to his receiver, no good.
Number 6 is the intended receiver on the play. That makes it 4th and 9.
And he muffed it. We're headed to the fourth quarter, and both of these defenses are still stealing the show. The Utes with a touchdown lead. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. A score here might effectively end this one. Utah is up by a touchdown. And he's tackled at the 30-yard line. And they make the stop around the 45-yard line. Brought down at the 43-yard line. He's on the run. Gains his way to the 33-yard line.
Gain of 10 on the play. That'll make it second and inches.
Keep it up, defense. Keep it up, guys. No tackle.
He's into the open field. Gets out to around the 18.
That's a gain of 15.
Come on, D.
First down.
Off inside. He makes it to the 18-yard line. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 18. Gets out to around the 9. Play, and it's going to be first and goal. Utah up 7 points. And they'll get him in the backfield.
Loss 1 yard on the play. That brings him second and goal.
Touchdown, Utes.
That is great, tough football right there. Getting down to the goal line and just punching it in.
And he adds the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Their last drive broke down and they punted. What do they have in store this time out? Halfback's got it on the quick throw. He's brought down in the open field. Through his hands. From their own 35-yard line. Second down.
Seven to Mike. Mike 7. Yeah.
Tries to thread the needle and it's not going to work. He's tackled at the 31-yard line.
That was perfect coverage against a pretty good route. He was all over that pass.
got a first and 10. Ball on the 31. It's the tailback. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line.
That makes it second and 8.
Just over 2 minutes in the game. Makes it to the 17. Utah State will take their first time out of the half. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
The defense doesn't seem to have an answer right now. They might need to change up some of their schemes.
So the defense has had enough of the no huddle. As they call a timeout, the fullback picks up about 3 yards on that carry.
Great play by the senior linebacker to step up in traffic and make that tackle.
Tackle made at the 2. A yard, if that, on the quarterback keeper. Got to be careful of a pass play with this defense. Splits the uprights with the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. Utah's just not going to let him come for air, I guess.
Well, this defense has just been stifling. They've shut down the running game. They've, for the most part, limited the big plays in the pass game. They've got a nice lead here in the fourth quarter.
An interception cut this offense last drive short, so I think they're going to be looking for a little more success right here.
And we'll see how aggressive this defense is when they come back out. I wouldn't be surprised if they kept up the pressure and try to fluster this quarterback some more. These short, effective passes are going to help the quarterback's confidence.
Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. And he stops the clock with a spike. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Dumps it incomplete. Wanted the screen.
Number 32, the entire receiver on the play.
Tight end right.
Fourth down.
Tight end right. Go down. Devin's in right.
There's a strike complete. And he's taken down at the 39. Downtown. The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 39. They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. Tackle right around the 46-yard line. And they're going to put 6 DBs on the field to counter that 5 receiver look. Under heavy pressure. Quick strike, and he drops it.
Number 85 was the intended receiver on the play.
And once again, the coaches decided to go for it on fourth down. should do it. A fourth down stop here late in the fourth quarter, and that should be the nail in the coffin in this game.
You know, the defensive line psyche right now is a little fragile. They better start to make some plays to start to regain their confidence, because right now they're just getting pushed around.
Nothing more demoralizing for a defense than seeing the opposing quarterback take a knee. And so that's going to do it. Our final score in this one, 28-7. Utah. So, Kirk, how would you sum up the action of this one?
Utah comes away with bragging rights this year, and I'm sure the fans and students will enjoy it just as much as the players. They were the better team today and added another great chapter to this rivalry.
That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.